Hey guys, welcome to Fun Learning. In this video, we are going to discuss about the deltoid muscle. With no more delay, let's get started. This is an extensor muscle of scapula, covers the shoulder from the lateral side, from the front, as well as from the behind. There comes a question, what is an extensor muscle? So extensor muscle are the muscle which are superficially located. And this deltoid muscle resembles the Greek letter delta, hence the name deltoid muscle. So now let us discuss about the origin of deltoid muscle in detail. This deltoid muscle has three fibers, namely anterior fiber, middle fiber and the posterior fiber. Among these three fibers, the anterior and the posterior are unipinnate fibers, whereas the middle is the multipinnate fiber. The anterior unipinnate clavicular fibers arises from the clavicle. I hope so you know the anatomy of the clavicle. The shaft of the clavicle is divided into medial 2/3 and the lateral 1/3. The lateral 1/3 is flat in nature, hence it has two surfaces and two borders. Two surfaces are superior surface, inferior surface, anterior border and the posterior border. So this anterior unipinnate clavicular fiber arises from the upper surface and anterior border of lateral 1/3 of clavicle. The middle multipinnate acromial fiber. Scapula has three processes, namely acromion process, spinous process and the coracoid process. This acromion process has two margin and two surface. Two margin are lateral margin and the medial margin. Two surface are superior surface and inferior surface. This middle multipinnate acromial fiber arises from the lateral margin and upper surface of acromion process. Next will be the posterior unipinnate spinous fiber. I already mentioned the scapula has three processes, namely first is acromion process, coracoid process and spinous process. This spinous process has two border, namely anterior border and the posterior border. The posterior fiber of the posterior border of the spinous process is called as crest of spine of scapula. This crest of spine of scapula has two lip, namely upper lip and lower lip. This posterior fiber arises from the lower lip of crest of spine of scapula. Okay, now let us discuss about the insertion of deltoid muscle in detail. The deltoid muscle, very easy, it inserted in the deltoid tuberosity, which is present on the lateral aspect of the shaft of the humerus. And this deltoid muscle is supplied by the axillary nerve. And action. So I already said this deltoid muscle has three fibers, anterior fiber, posterior fiber and the middle fiber. The anterior fiber helps in flexion and the medial rotation. Exactly ulta of it is done by the posterior fiber, namely extension and lateral rotation. The middle fibers of deltoid helps in abduction. Okay, now let us discuss about the relation of deltoid muscle in detail. This is a diagram that you have to draw if they ask a deltoid muscle during exams. Okay, so by seeing this diagram, you can say that this deltoid muscle overlies the humerus, the articulation between the scapula and humerus, namely the shoulder joint, and the connection between the coracoid process and the acromion process, which is nothing but coracoacromial ligament. So this deltoid muscle overlies the humerus, shoulder joint and the coracoacromial ligament. And this is also related to the following structure, namely first we'll discuss about the origin of the muscle. This deltoid muscle is related to the long and short head of biceps brachii, coracobrachialis, long and lateral head of triceps. Insertion of muscle, just try to remember PSIT. P stands for pectoris major and minor, S stands for supraspinatus, I stands for infraspinatus, T stands for teres major and minor. Next will be the vessels and nerves. So axillary nerve, anterior and posterior circumflex humeral artery, intermuscular space, quadrangular space and triangular space, and bursa, subscapular bursa, subdeltoid bursa, subacromial bursa and the infraspinatus bursa. Now let us discuss about the clinical application of deltoid muscle in detail. First will be doctors used to put injection at the deltoid muscle only. So it is a most common site for intramuscular injection. Second is, I already said this deltoid muscle is supplied by the axillary nerve. If there is any damage to axillary nerve, then the deltoid muscle will be paralyzed. With this, I'm completing today's video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching. Stay home and stay safe.